You're listening to WGSR, bringing hope and comfort to the world 24 hours a day.
Hi, I'm Suzanne Lynn from Z88.3 Afternoons with Suzanne and Shadow. Join my friends Mike, Fritz, and Trish on WGSR, bringing hope, comfort, and encouragement to the world 24 hours a day.
God's Stories Radio, a podcast to heal your soul, bringing you hope and comfort through the power of Christian testimony. God's Stories Radio, a podcast to heal your soul, is coming up.
And welcome to God Stories Radio. This is session 92. I'm Mike.
I'm Fritz.
No Trish.
No Trish tonight.
Taking care of the little one.
Yeah, she texted me late this afternoon, said she wasn't going to make it because Kate was sick. So our prayers and heart goes out to her tonight.
Absolutely.
I know she's been battling some things.
She has, you know, is just like our guest tonight. She's being put through the test ringer.
We've all been through the test ringer.
And some of us are still in
so
it.
So to speak.
Yeah.
Some of us are just going around in circles like a
That's a good way to put it.
Hamster cage. Yeah. You know, just going nowhere fast.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, we've got some shout-outs tonight.
Oh, yeah.
All right, sweet. I know we're in 52 countries. The top three, other than the United States, is Canada, China, and the U.K.
All right, thanks.
So we welcome
thanks for those countries
those
and all
listeners,
those listeners.
And we thank you so much. So I'll bounce it over to you, and who else we got?
And our Facebook likes is Terry Rents, Amber Hickman Gomez, and Mark Elvis Amigo.
Terry, Amber, and Mark, thank you so much.
Thank you for listening.
For listening and
liking
us.
Us on Facebook.
Thank you so much. And if you listen to us on iHeartRadio, make sure you follow us.
Follow us there, yes.
On there as well so that we can keep track of you. And speaking of keeping track, I got a very, very nice note from a lady named Wendy today. She just wrote me a short note saying that she found us on iHeartRadio and that GSR has been a tremendous blessing in her life. And Wendy, Mikey and I just want to thank you for taking the time to sit down and jot us a little note. You have no idea how much encouragement that is to us.
Absolutely.
Because sometimes you get weary and well-doing and you wonder, hey, are you making a difference?
Right. And those little encouragement letters, they do help. And sometimes some of you people out there, listeners, how about turning some of those little encouragement letters into some testimonies?
Yeah. Hey, we're not scared to read them. You don't have to be on the show or appear or call in or anything like that. If you want to jot down a testimony and or a life occurrence of some kind, I mean, we've
done them before.
Some of those too, you know, just something that happened in your life that turned your head, or maybe it was
a God thing. Right. We did one of them that was a 2-hour stint in a guy's day that was just screaming came from God.
Yeah, it was amazing. It was an amazing story. So this is God Stories Radio, so any God stories are perfectly welcome. So all right. Well, enough of our babbling. I'd like to welcome our guest tonight. We have Craig, a.k.a. Plate, has come in, and he's going to share. This is part two.
Yes, an update.
A testimony, an update. This is our first one that's come in and updated us, and this brother's been through quite a bit. I mean, he shared some stuff with us prior to the show, and I am blown away that he's here and that he's
still clean and sober.
Still clean and sober, sitting in front of us. And Craig, a.k.a. Plate, has a music and art festival coming up. And Craig, I'll let you tell the folks about that.
Well, it is called the Delanda Palooza. And it's an original music and art festival. that well, there'll be 150 bands that take over downtown DeLand. So in DeLand, the downtown will be shut down, pretty much the historical downtown, and all the venues and events will take place in those different, you know, establishments all throughout that. It's $10 in advance for the tickets for the all day venue pass, and $15 at the gate for all. That's an all venue pass, which gets you from 1 p.m. to 1 a.m. the next day. So, fantastic. It's a lot of music, and it's an opportunity for a lot of bands and musicians to get out there and show their stuff. Mm-hmm. And there's promoting going on, of course, and then t-shirts, you know what I mean, all kinds of stuff going on. Actually, there's going to be a TV channel out there in the morning doing something, a clip. So it'll be on TV too. So it's pretty cool. All right. I've been doing original music in Florida since 1994. So, you know, I've been promoting and you know, doing the original music scene since, you know, then. And, you know, of course, I try to do it in my own way. And, it, well, God didn't want that to happen.
It doesn't work out, does it?
No, but it's all changed now because, you know, I'm doing it God's way. And so,
God typically has different plans since his thoughts are not our thoughts.
Absolutely.
Mysterious.
And Craig is actually back. I forget what number his testimony is. You remember what it is?
Like 56 or something. 56. Rock On.
Rock On is the name of it, yeah.
52.
Yeah, I think it is 52.
Wow, that's 52. 50, this 52, is 92.
51, yeah, something like that.
Yeah, something like that. Anyhow, time flies, you know. That was like a year and a half ago about?
I know.
Yeah. That's why I'm here, to give an update.
It sounds kind of funny saying session 52.
Yeah.
We never thought we'd ever do that many.
This is blatant.
Well, there's people that said that they didn't think we were going to stick around for 15. But anyway, this is the first one that we've had. It's coming in to do an update. So, and...
Yeah, absolutely. That's what I'm here for, is to share. The following year actually has been a blast, and it's been a learning experience, clean and sober. I'm celebrating 3 years, 6 months.
Oh, fantastic.
That's the longest I've been clean and sober since I'm 13.
Wow.
I'm 50 years old already.
That's great, Craig. Congratulations.
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, I just wanted to segue into, you know, introduce you. This is Craig, and a really good friend of the show and a good friend of mine. He had a band, and he played at my proposal.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
that's right.
Singles event. So appreciate him for that. Like Mikey said, Craig is back for round two. He's come to give us an update on what's going on, and I know it's going to be good because I know where this brother's come from. And the very fact that he's sitting right here telling his story is a miracle within itself. So without further ado, here's Craig.
Hey, all right. Well, rock on.
But, rock on, brother.
Yeah, well, you know, that's what I say. My foot is on the rock and my name is on the roll. You see? Yeah, all right. Anyhow, a lot of blessings all around this last since I've talked to you, from family to recovery to financial, from good to bad. I mean, I've learned to trust God in all things. Some important verses I hold dear are Jeremiah 29:11 and Isaiah 41:10. They're life verses. I mean, I remind myself as tools to carry on with a mission of delivering the message of Jesus and transformation by the Word and Spirit of God. Jesus has blessed me with the ability to do this with my gift, and that is of music. Through music, I have connected with both churches and the community. Also with ability, with the community, also with the ability to lead at the Celebrate Recovery here at the FUMC, or First United Methodist Church in Claremont, where I use my guitar and testimony of recovery to help others find the way with Christ at the center.
Amen.
Outreaching into the community with music has been awesome also. God opened the doors for me to work with two church praise and worship bands since I've been here, and I'm still with them. The FUMC and South Lake Presbyterian Worship. With these bands, I was able to get us into what was called the Pig on the Pond. It's the largest event in Claremont, and also the Claremont Music Festival, both large events in the community. It's the first time that the church has had the opportunity to join the community and share contemporary Christian music in these festivals. So,
that's great.
Yeah. I mean, well, you know, Mike Lohman, the leader at FUMC Praise Band, said, Craig, why don't you be an ambassador and, you know, see what you can do for us on the outreach side? I said, you got it. You know it. And I prayed on it. And sure enough, God opened the doors. And it's just like walking through them, you know, just, okay, all right.
And who knows where that's going to go.
And it worked. And it's just amazing how he connects people. And, you know, I see God, a revelation of God through people that are true believers, you know, through that, you know, we connect in different ways and help each other. So anyhow, also with music, something very special happened. Me and my dad have united our family, family reunion, which was, you know, the large family reunion. Every 5 years we have a really big one. My dad's a child of a family of 13.
So, oh, wow.
Yeah, you know, so by now we have like hundreds. So we had a huge family reunion in Ohio, and at this time we were able to enjoy some quality time doing what was the first Fraley worship band at our annual Fraley reunion in Ohio.
Wow.
Yeah. That's huge.
That's fantastic.
So me, my dad sang, I play guitar, and then we had one of the other you know, relatives play bass, and one of the other relatives play drums. And wow, we had a praise band at the reunion. It was like so cool. You know, that's just the first time. People were kind of freaking out. Of course, I'm looking at people like, who are you? Oh, you're my cousin? You're my cousin? No. Really? First cousin, second cousin, whatever. Anyhow, so that's great. But then, you know, I was also able to enjoy some quality time with my children and my grandkids. I have 4 grandkids now. And, yeah, and my 3 daughters. But I only have reunited with 2 of them. The youngest one I have not seen yet. I've talked to her, and I'm going to see her soon. I know the Lord's going to open the doors.
Same with me. My youngest daughter still is estranged from me. And I know the Father will set that up.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, then we're right there together on that one. So that comes to a total of, you know, 4 grandkids. And the whole family, you know, the whole Fraley family, it was great to have a reunion and be able to unite with them. It's the first time I've done it clean and sober. So, you know, this whole new approach.
You know what happened. You know everything that went on.
For once, exactly. I won't say what happened last time I went to one. Last time I went to a full family reunion was 20 years ago. So you can see how, yeah, it took me this step and all the sequence of stuff to happen before it would happen again like it did. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the important thing I try to stress is, you know, it just wasn't plop landed in my lap. Oh, okay, well, he just became clean and sober and all this good stuff happened. No. I had to make the right choices. I had to do work. I had to get on my knees. I had to serve the Lord. You know what I mean? There are choices that I had to specifically make for this to happen. Mm-hmm. You know, God doesn't just throw stuff in your lap. You know, he wants you to work for it. He wants you to serve him and prove yourself.
Right.
He does. He tests us.
Absolutely.
That way. You know what I mean? I've been through certain tests that, you know, I've succeeded through, and because of that, I'm rewarded.
Amen.
It's kind of cool.
And doors are opening.
Yeah, and doors are opening. And what I would never imagine would happen, you know, and it is happening. So anyhow, also at Celebrate Recovery, I was given the opportunity to co-lead a step study. And that lasted for an entire year in about a month. And, you know, me and another leader took a group of men through the principles, eight principles, and 12 steps of recovery, and just watch it change lives.
Oh, know? It does.
It's so cool. And then be able to present them with a certificate. I can remember when I was presented with a certificate. Here I am given, you know, doing it. It's so cool.
It is, isn't it?
To be in that, to get that opportunity. So now I'll be able to, now I did co-lead, now I can lead a step study. Of course, I'm taking a year off. They say take a year off, a year on, that kind of. So that was my second step study to complete, but they're great. I mean, Celebrate Recovery and the step studies is just something that would definitely change your life.
It would.
You know what I mean?
They do.
You know what I'm talking about.
Absolutely.
Yes, sir. And the other thing awesome is just the fact of being able to participate in the praise and worship band. We've been able to raise the bar and, you know, play quality contemporary Christian music and for these people. And, you know, that helps. Music is so huge in what it does.
Absolutely.
For people.
I couldn't agree more.
I'm just, you know, it's amazing how
international language.
Yeah. It's universal, actually. I say universal.
Yeah, that's the word I was looking for. You betcha.
That's part of what gets me through my day.
Is music.
Not only reading the Bible and praying to the Father, but the music, the contemporary Christian music just helps.
There's something about that.
Along. Absolutely.
With the Spirit of God, it's amazing what music can do because, well, hey, you know, I mean, you have the Spirit of God with you. You're anointed with the Spirit. So... but you know, I mean, music is deep because it is natural and we're just tapping into the sound waves that God created naturally. You know what I mean? It's, we make our, we imitate, let's say the sound wave. You know, we imitate with our instruments and our digital equipment, the sounds that God actually created you know, in the beginning.
Oh, absolutely.
From the beginning. So anyhow, getting back to what I was saying, I've been given the opportunity to lead the praise and worship band also. So I've got experience in leading the team. You know, so there are times when the leader had to step out, and I was able to step in.
Right,
that's cool. So, also another thing is I've been able to complete. I'm on my third semester or third year with Real Freedom at Real Life.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I'm leading there, too, and that's just awesome. Are you okay? Yeah. You know, I lead in the small groups, and it's just great to see how God works with the Word and communication with the guys that are trying to learn from it in different topics, you know. We're talking about the kingdom of God now, so.
Right. And God takes you through those things so you can actually help others. That's the verse for God Stories Radio is 2 Corinthians 1:3-4, where, you know, God has comforted you and now you are to go and comfort others in the same way.
I understand. I understand that now.
That was paraphrased, but.
No, I mean, you know, yeah. That's part of our spiritual growth so that we can help others. I mean, we help ourselves by helping others. You know what I mean? I always get that too, you know?
It oh, you do. It's me. Healing.
I learned that a long time ago because, you know, after I started teaching private music lessons, the more I was teaching and going over the same things over and over and over again, it was helping me. You know, of course, I wasn't in recovery at the time, but it was helping me musically wise, you know?
Uh-huh.
I mean, the music was, you know what I mean? I was writing and composing and, you know, working in a music shop and teaching theory and you know what I mean? And it just really, I had like 30 or 40 students a week. So anyhow, let me continue. Today's Thursday. Yeah, God has also given me the ability to share with the residents of Superior Nursing Home. Superior, you know where that is?
No.
That's over by the hospital across the street.
Oh, yeah.
Superior.
Yeah.
And
right across from the hospital.
I know where it is. They have a memory care there. And these you know, people are actually locked into this environment and they can't leave, you know, because they're memories, you know, I mean, they're just, you know, their memories are, you know, they're having problems and they're older and they're, you know. So what I do is I go in there. This morning I went in there and with a couple other missionaries, and we go in there and have a group setting, and I get up there with my guitar and just start picking away and picking and grinning and singing, and they love it.
Sure they do.
And I've been doing it for, you know, a year and a half. There are people there that know me specifically, and you know, I'm able to help them that way, you know, linked to their past, I guess. You
right.
know what I mean? So it's really neat. It's just, I definitely feel blessed when I leave there.
And God will bless that.
Yes, sir. So amazing what music can do for the memory. So, you know, I just go into the memory care with the gift of music and sharing the saving grace of Jesus Christ. Of course, I do include that. Mm-hmm. John 3:16 is our most popular verse there. And Jesus Loved Me is a very popular song there.
I'm sure.
So anyhow, also, God has given me the opportunity to share music with the kids from the Vineyard Single Mothers with Children nonprofit organization. It's called the Vineyards, and it's a community that supports single mothers with children. And,
okay.
Yeah, and then through a process of this year and a half, I've had to move different locations, but throughout the locations, I've been able to bless a mother's children, you know, the mother's children with something.
Right.
Music wise. It could be just strumming a guitar or talking about notes or something. But now I'm God's got me with a mother that's a mother of five children, single mother. Yeah, and she's doing well and blessed, and it's just great. I go in there, and I just had a group session yesterday with them, and, you know, sharing music, and it's just wild how I was sharing about music and about the nature of tones and sound waves like we were just talking about. And she goes, hey, yeah, we were just talking about that in science class just this week. And I'm like, whoa, that just links right up. Thank you, Lord. So, you know, she was able to relate to me about what I was saying, you know, about sound waves,
mm-hmm.
you know, and tones and notes, of course, A, B, C, D, F, G. A, B, C, D, F, G, A, B, C, D, F, G. It's amazing how it just keeps going around in a circle like that, you know. So, anyhow, also, okay, let's see. So I really enjoy sharing the understanding of music and notes and rhythm with the children. And I do get record. I'll tell you what, pretty much I do get record. I get pictures of the stuff, accounts, so that I have, you know, actual evidence of what I'm doing. And I post them on Facebook or on Google or, you know, throughout the internet. So that way, you know what I mean? I keep record of it. And others through music. I am using this as an outreach also into the world and using my talents and music abilities on a plate to share the message of Jesus Christ to everybody. Everybody, anybody Jesus wants to use it for.
Amen.
So that's awesome. It's an outreach and inreach or whatever you call it. I don't know what you call it. Local and outreach, you know. This is my center hub. You know, and from here I can outreach from Claremont.
Right.
It's Central Florida, right? So it makes sense. So anyhow, so I'm using this as an outreach into the world and using my talents and music abilities to share the message of Jesus Christ and salvation and, you know, the Bible. By showing them how God's grace and mercy has changed my life for the good. Now that I'm clean and sober for now 3 years, 6 months. Praise God.
Amen. That's awesome.
All right. Now, also, yes, something else. I'm also using my teaching abilities to teach private music instruction only with a few students, showing how all music is Christ-centered and just how we see it is how what makes a difference, a matter of perspective on how you see the notes. You'll notice that it reflects Jesus Christ, that it's Christ-centered. Yep. No matter what, all this crazy music you've heard, and what they say it is, it all came from the Creator.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
You know,
to
just
that.
Like, you know, you can use metal in all kinds of different ways. You know what I mean? Music is sound waves. You can use it all kinds of different ways, but it came from the Creator.
Absolutely.
So you bet.
That's what I, you know, that's how
Amen
I share.
Amen to that.
You know what I mean? And it's there's actual proof of that over and over, teaching and playing. I just absolutely stand on music being Christ-centered. So it's really neat that I can share that. If you'd like a lesson, just you know, let them know, God Stories Radio, or let me know. Maybe if it's the Lord's will, that it'll happen. Anyhow, most importantly, I must come back to what's called media. Media community. It's a African Inland Missions Christ-centered community. It's a central hub from which God has used to show me his love and mercy, the power of prayer, also giving me the ability to serve Jesus with people who have known me since I was a child in Africa. I would never imagine coming here and becoming part of a community, you know, years ago, years apart, that knew me as a kid. While I was at the Salvation Army going through their rehab program, changing my lifestyle from drugs and alcohol and worldly living, God showed me the importance of serving and using my talents for Him. My parents live in media and wanted to help see me get a fresh start on a new life, clean and sober, Christ-centered. And, you know, I owe it all to their love and yours, you know, and all of Claremont in this whole area, in Salvation Army. None of this would have taken place without you and Jesus Christ at the center. And of course, playing music with the residents at media is awesome too. I've learned the structures of hymns, old school hymns.
Right.
I mean, all the hymns, man, these ladies play like, we have two grand pianos and they just go in there and play them like you wouldn't believe. It's amazing. And I have to keep up with them on a guitar. And they have 10 fingers, and I only got 4 to use. So it's like I'm sweating. Yeah, I'm sweating when I'm playing with them. I'm like, and they, you know, now I got all these eyes on me. Like, when is he going to make a mistake? But it's good. It's taught me a lot about playing hymns, old school hymns and stuff. So I've learned. I got a whole stack of music that I've collected over the, you know, years, year and a half. Since I talked to a whole stack of music, all printed music that I've saved of all the music I've played over and over, you know, throughout the years, you know. So anyhow, the key verses that I use is Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you."
Plans to give you hope in a future.
Yeah.
Amen.
You know that one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you bet.
How about Proverbs 3:5-6? And then we just...
Yes, trust the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Lean on Him, and He will make your path straight.
Straight. Yes, lean on Him. Submit to Him. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I had to learn that.
Oh, yeah, really, we all do.
Ooh. It's like, oh, did we have an earthquake or what was that? That was a tone. That was a B flat, 24 octaves lower.
Yeah.
Than middle C. Anyhow, Philippians 4:13. How about that one? I can do all things through Christ, Him who strengthens me.
Strength.
And then last but not least, my life verse, which is Isaiah 41:10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, I will help thee, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. He gave that to me after a motorcycle wreck in 11th grade. I was in a coma for 2 weeks. When I came out of that coma, bam, that verse was there, and it's been with me all my life. I couldn't get rid of it as I was living in the world. It never left my mind, but I tried. I tried to run from it. I tried. Let me
haven't we all, you know?
Over and over again, you know? So that's basically in a nutshell. I do have a final statement that I want to say about everything to conclude.
Go ahead.
You want me to do it now?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Floor is yours, my brother.
All right. Praise the Lord. All right. I've experienced a lot of different things this past year. I've connected with friends of mine from high school to family reunions to just jamming in events to even gaining financial freedom to, you know, almost getting married. I've had a lot of good times and a lot of bad times. It is something I must say has given me strength and shown my weaknesses. I look to and read the Word of God. I am active in recovery and stay in touch with others going through recovery successfully. I've watched my mother, then my father's health go bad, to trusting the Lord that they still stay alive. I've given my talents to the Lord on a plate, both in ministry and in outreach. I've had my trust ripped apart by someone I trusted my whole life with. It is amazing how God shuts the door with people and how we must trust in Him that this happens to protect us. I have watched it happen to others and experienced it myself. Lies and manipulation. The main thing I must say is actions are louder than words. The verse that I lean on with life situations is Psalms 118:8, the center verse of the Bible. Hopefully, the people I do trust now won't be like some that have not been able to be true to their words. But I am told that I need to forgive in my recovery, but it is hard. Not being able, it's hard to forget, actually. God's love is given through Jesus Christ to my enemies, but my personal love is not so easily given. Anyhow, I am so blessed with all the good things God is going on in my life, and God is helping me every day stay clean and sober. I am clean and sober 3 years and 6 months, one day at a time. So rock on.
Rock on.
Rock
on. Rock on.
And on and on and on and on and on and on. And on.
Really?
I'm not going to stop, bro.
Brother, I just think it's so cool how you've used music as a blessing, as a teaching it, as a language, so to speak.
Yep.
In unity in the community.
Teaching kids how to interpret music.
With Christ.
With Christ, right?
Yeah, that's so cool.
Yeah, it is. Thanks for helping me complete that sentence, because that's exactly what I was trying to say. You know, being a musician myself, I have a lot of appreciation for that. And knowing where you've come from, brother, I'm so proud of you.
Absolutely. And then, again, what he's gone through in the past few months, and to still be clean and sober, it didn't fall. That's all God's strength, as you were reading. It just came from Him.
Yep. He can only
it has to stronger. Be, because I'm telling you what, if it was on my own, dude, I would be out and about right now, or dead, actually. I'd be dead. If I go back out and then, you know, fall, I'm going to die. And and my music's going to stop. And that can't happen. No way. Mm-hmm. I have a song, and in that song I say, you know, we are the army of salvation. We journey all across the nation, waving our banners up high, because it's for Christ that I will die. And that's the reason why I'm transformed.
Yeah! Yeah! Amen.
Whoa, whoa. There goes that earthquake.
Yeah.
Plate moves mountains.
That was me.
Plate moves mountains. That's what I say to people. They go, what kind of plate? A dinner plate? No, I said the plate that holds your body together, a plate that moves mountains. But, you know, it's an offering plate too, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I pull up a Google search plate, and there's like 23 million different, you know, definite term, you know, ways to use that term. I'm like, wow.
Man, that was good.
It's good. Yeah, I'm glad to see Greg still sober and clean and
writing music. My latest release, yeah, Soul Night.
And you know, God will continue to bless that as long as you continue to walk in His path.
Yeah, but it's that choice, right? I have to continue to walk in that path.
Absolutely.
you know, I can't go, oh, well, I'm just going to go out and slip for a little while. And, you know, he'll, you know, it don't really work that way. I mean, he does have grace, but I'll tell you what, every time you do that, he's going to get harder and harder and harder.
Not only that, we were talking last week, Mikey, about he'll put you on the shelf.
Yep.
If you don't protect that testimony.
Oh, yeah.
Put you on the shelf. Absolutely.
There you go.
Yeah, he will.
He will.
And you were talking about protecting your music and your love for it and the fact that he's blessing you through it.
Mm-hmm.
You're spot on, brother.
Absolutely.
Right. Yeah. That's what's keeping me clean and sober is the music, to be honest with you. You know what I mean? That's really, I laid it down the first 5 months of my recovery when I was, you know, in the rehab. I laid down music and it just, sure enough, you know, my first opportunity to play music in a whole new genre of contemporary Christian music, I was given the opportunity to play music. You know what? With what instrument? The organ.
Really?
That was my first opportunity. I'm like, I was looking at hymnal. I'm looking at contemporary music and I just got the chord charts and I'm like, okay, I know these chords, but wow. Two layers of keys, you know, I'm like, foot pedals. I'm like, oh, Lord.
Oh, at least it was a B. At least it was a B3, brother. You'd look
cool.
It
was old school, yeah.
You'd look cool doing it, you know?
It was fun. I mean, I was playing around with the volume, you know, pedal. Wow, wow. I'm like, oh, yeah, do. But, you know, it's amazing that after I did that for, you know, like for a few weeks, the guitarist ended up falling and relapsing, and they needed a guitarist, and guess who was there?
Me.
They're like,
it's just another open door, another blessing.
It's sad for him, but you know what, now he's come back and he has made the right choices and he's doing really good in the Salvation Army, and you know what I mean, he finally, but it's not harder as you keep doing, you know, making bad choices. It really is.
Well, you know that firsthand.
Oh, absolutely. So, you know, that's – but anyhow, so, yeah, I had the opportunity to play guitar, and then next thing you know, I mean, I was jamming full-time with this band, and, you know, we call One Accord is what the name of their band at Salvation Army is. And it's contemporary Christian, but they use a lot of, like, you know, blue – some black gospel, you know, kind of music, too.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah, I was groovy, man. I was grooving. You know, it just shot off. I mean, I started playing with them. Next thing you know, we were in a Salvation Army camp playing. Next thing you know, we were at the Salvation Army headquarters in Atlanta, Georgia, playing. Here I am playing a song by Sly and the Family Stone with a wall pedal in the headquarters of Salvation Army. And I'm like, are you serious? Of course, they changed the lyrics to the song. I can't remember which one it was, but it's one of them really grooving songs. And I was using the wall pedal, and there's like, you know, thousands of Salvation Army people. And I'm like, wow, wow, wow. You know, I'm like, wow, this is amazing. Then we did a conference in Lake Junaluska in North Carolina in the middle of the Blue Ridge Mountains. Then we came back and they brought a team down to record a CD of our One Accord music. I mean, just bam, 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 bam. It all just started happening. It's like, okay, Lord, you want me to do this. And then next thing you know, I'm here in Claremont and they need a guitarist for Celebrate Recovery. And then next thing you know, I got in with the Lord just opened doors.
Mm-hmm.
And now
that's his job.
Yeah.
He is the door prior opener.
But you know, what I like to... I'm assured that, you know, you're on the right path when you see fruit. You know what I mean? You got to see fruit. You got to bear fruit. Just like this. I mean, just coming into the studio, or when I saw it online, you know, I was like, dude, this is fruit. You guys are doing a good thing. You know what I mean?
You bet.
Of course, you know, you've been doing a good thing for quite a while. But it's all in God's timing.
It'll be what?
How long have you been doing this?
It'll be 3 years this May.
Coming up, 3 years.
Yeah.
We still don't know what we're going to do for our 100th episode.
Oh, yeah.
Session.
Oh, you haven't gotten there yet.
Yeah, we got to have some kind of a something.
Invite, some kind of a something.
Invite some people in that been on the show that were instrumental in some kind of a party or something.
That would be cool. Yeah, you should do that. Definitely.
Maybe we could hire...
Yeah, or hire just have a few of the guests coming in that were...
Guitar work and
you bet, man. Well, Craig, thanks for coming by, brother. Like Mikey said earlier, you are our first kind of part two, but I'm so glad you stopped by. And, you know, Craig shared some things prior to us coming online, and, you know, he's really been through some things, and he's really had an opportunity to relapse. And I just got to say, I am impressed. And I think I thank Jesus. I thank the Lord that you're sitting here clean and sober.
Absolutely.
And I thank the Lord for you all.
We're breaking bread together. And I just.
I am clean and sober.
Yeah. You know it, buddy. Very, very proud of you.
And, you know, it's just amazing that God rewards those who diligently seek him.
Mm-hmm. Those who digitally seek him.
Diligently. Digitally. Yeah, I like that. That's like, in God's name we play instead of pray.
That's right.
In God's name we play.
Uh-huh.
Jam on. Rock on.
Rock on.
Anyhow, I got some new releases. Plates got some new releases. And Plate also has a full band now. God blessed me with drummer.
Fantastic.
And, rhythm guitarist, bass player. The singer part, not yet. I'm having to sing, and I really am not a singer, so I'm an instrumentalist mainly, but I just growl, you know. I growl. So they call it grunge, and I'm like, what? I'm not grunge. I'm melodic metal. Power metal.
There you go. You know, big difference.
White metal.
Get educated about your metal already.
So I just want to let you know, we are Centropy Music's having an event in downtown Orlando. God's Open the Doors. It's going to be three Believer bands playing in downtown Orlando, May 13th. It's on a Friday the 13th. It'll be from 9 at night till 2 in the morning, and we are just going to have at it. It's called A Warfare of a Spirit Kind, and we're having at it. It's an outside stage. It's really neat, and it's really in a historic area where a lot of bands have played. So.
And cool. You can go to www.ssa.cc for more information.
All righty then.
That's right. And you can drop us a line at godstoriesradio@gmail.com if you need more information. And you can also what, Mike?
Tweet us.
You can tweet us.
Absolutely.
On Twitter at godstoriesradio. Like us on Facebook, facebook.com/godstoriesradio. Like us on iHeartRadio.
iHeartRadio.
And we just thank each and every one of you for being faithful to listen.
Absolutely.
And sending us those notes saying that we've blessed you. And I should say the Father's blessed you and through us. You know,
absolutely.
We're nothing, yes. Really. Yeah.
But through
we're
us.
Not the, we're not
us.
The blessing, right?
But he's through just, us. That's the cool thing.
That's right. In us and through us. So, yeah, you got anything else, Mikey?
All I'm thinking of right now is... there is a donate button.
Yes, there is.
A donate button. We are actually, Fritz is in the hole for about 1,000. So if you feel God tugging on your heart, please push the button.
We appreciate it. Those taxes were a surprise.
That was a surprise. Absolutely.
That was a surprise. But praise God, we had the means to do it. So anyway, we just love and appreciate all of you. So. Craig, thanks again for coming by.
Thank you, Craig.
Sir.
And try to get out to the Delanda Palooza if you can.
And when was the date on that?
That was April the 9th at 6:15 p.m. and that's Stage 15.
So yes, Stage 15 is on the back alley out.
Back alley, and you can go to ssa.cc for more information on that.
So, yeah, and the Centropy Music event downtown Orlando at Orlando Brewing.
Yes, sir.
It'll be May 13th, Friday. And it'll be three Believer bands. Melting metal is what we say. We melt metal.
Awesome. Be there. Aloha. Now I'm telling on my edge from 5-0.
Aloha. Anyway. Is that what you said?
Aloha.
Yeah, that's what he there. Said.
Aloha. Jumbo Buana.
All right. Man, what a great time. Thanks again, Craig, for coming by. That wraps it up for session 92. I'm Fritz.
I'm Mike.
God bless you.
God bless.
Innocence is calling the way it's always been. I can feel my heart is reaching. I can see the calling to show your heart within. 'Cause I'm